Okay, now here I'll tell you a little about the whole plantation of Oliajawa. Okay, let's deal like this. With this packet, Oliajawa. I'll change the marker, it's not called I'll change the and you see that in V, the V a vector space. We suppose in this case that it is a finite of dimension. It's a finite dimensional vector space. And you see that the rho is a representation of this algebra on V, representation of J on this vector space. That means that if first of all here is a normal morphism also rho is a normal morphism rho is a in the moment of this. It's a moment of this also here to project on this one into this kind of algebra, the algebra of your vector space. Such that this, first of all, moment of this of here, such that and in the second time, rho of the bracket y like this is also equal to the bracket of the image like this. The rho of that is the normal phase of the of Lie algebra, because this one is a local Lie algebra, and this one is also Lie algebra. Like the Lie algebra of endomorphism of this kind of vector space is. The first one, that means that x of alpha y plus beta y just equal to alpha here plus beta y, beta rho of y. And the second like that, you just this one. So you have rho is a homomorphism, rho is a homomorphism of the algebra. From your vector space into this color here, there but also on vector. It's a representation of D on this kind of vector space, which is a finite dimensional vector space. Okay, there is a particular case of vector space for all x, y. In this, in your Lie algebra, let's set your bracket S Y like this. You set is equal to A D X of Y. Like this, you put like this, and then from here, we can see that from here you see that it of E for all x in J is it also a double morphism of this your Lie algebra. Then you can also put that the AD here is also the representation of the algebra into the same piece algebra, which is called the adjoint representation. Called adjoint representation. So the vector space here is just the Lie algebra itself.
still got adjoint to the partition, so you can pull easily by your input easily that for first of all by the alpha y plus beta alpha x plus beta y. You can put easily that alpha ad of x plus beta ad of y, very simple. And you can put also that ad of the bracket is the bracket of adx ADY, just what the two conditions. We should say that this is really a representation of J on J. Here is another morphism. The bracket here is that the composition is AD of X composite with AD of Y minus AD of Y composite with AD of X. Is that another morphism? Remember that this is a linear algebra, but the bracket for any endomorphism is that this the bracket of here, this kind of endomorphism is F composite with J minus J composite for any endomorphism which is the bracket defined on the endomorphism, you should see like this, which happened here. So for proof here, you can just use the Jacobi identity. Jacobi identity to prove it. Jacobi identity, you can prove it. But this one very, 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 very easy. So you have a particular case of representation called the adjoint representation of your diagram. Can put the adjoint representation of the diagram. You can define another representation also. When I take J, limit of J1, the linear length of this, we suppose that G is a linear. So when you are in a state like this, I can compute and add here the limit of the linear algebra, and then also G X. This one is also of the limit of the linear algebra. I have this. You just prove easily that you can just compute because when you compute the exponential t of dx t plus 1 is exactly g the exponential tx. D minus one. And you define that this one is the limit of the group. This one is in the group. If this is the group, that means that this is the linear algebra. Very, very simple. So I repeat again. You have this equality. D is the limit of the group. This is the limit of this one. This X here of the algebra. The group, the product is the group. Then this is your algebra for all D here. Then you can define. And you can define a map like this. A map from all D. From all D like this, for all D, you can associate this kind of map like this. This kind of map which will be like this. From all J, you can put it that way. So, from automorphism of this kind of Lie algebra, which will be denoted by the J. It will be just a notation, which is called the A. ED of J. Which is the homomorphism of here the notomorphic of T, which is the Lie algebra for all X, you have this kind of this AG of J of X, which is exactly what I put here, this one, which is exactly J, X, J, this one. So I define the map, so I define the map of J, of L, which is this G, X, J, minus 1. Then we have also did. Then we can prove easy that AD here is also a representation. Now is a roof of the group on the Lie algebra. It's also called the adroit representation of your group now, not the Lie algebra. Is a adroit representation. Adroit representation of the group, of the linear group, of this linear group, which is linear group, which is that, which is called the adjoint operator of linear group. You can prove easily that this is an automorphism. For all G here, for all G here, this map generated by G is a automorphism of this kind of Lie algebra. You can say very easy to prove. Is a surjective and so on. This is. AD is injective and subjective. It's a one-to-one and also subjective. It's very simple to prove. So you have this kind of one. You have this AD of D map here. For all parts you have what this collision. You have G, S, G, G, minus. So you have this one. Also, it's injective. Yeah, it's also injective. Then it's an automorphism of this this structure. Okay. Now, with something you can use here, you can prove that just property one. You can prove that what is the equation. Can ask that what is the correspondence between the adjoint of a group and this one, which is of the Lie algebra, they could be for this which is the representation of the groups. It's a representation of a Lie algebra, it's a group. I remind you that AD of X like this for Y is just a bracket. Or here, AD of J of Y is that G, what is X here? X, G minus 1. Now, what the relationship we can get between the two? This I would like to tell you. What kind of relationship we can get from the two? I'm trying to mark up, I'll put a good mark up in this. What kind of relationship can get this? You can prove that for properties one, you can prove that the derivative of here, it's not good, this one, of AD at 0 is exactly what you get. In the first result, we can easily prove. That means that what? If you want to prove it, when you complete this, for example, for all X, Y, derivative of your group, I complete this one. DD, derivative of ED, E of X of Y, is what exactly the derivative of T of this one parameter sum of the image of the exponential tx y. When t tend to zero, we have this notation. And now we try to compute now here. You compute now and you compute it and you have the result. The adjoint of the exponential t x y is exactly the exponential t x y, the exponential minus t x y, minus t x in the distance. When now, when you compute the derivative of this, of here, the derivative of here is exactly the same. Will be at t equal to zero, will be exactly x y minus y x, which is just the adjoint of x of y. You complete it. Yeah. Because if you complete, you have this. The derivative of this, you have something like that, the exponential tx. First of all, then you have s here, y, the exponential of tx, ty, like this. And y, like this, minus, we put the derivative now, the exponential tx y and minus x, if we got this kind of, yeah, y, yeah, this is s, the minus x, yeah, and the exponential of minus tx, this minus this one. If you compute this, you compute this kind of derivative here, you compute, you have this kind of form. When t tend to zero, you have xy minus y by x, which is exactly the bracket for the matrix. I see that you have your indicate where G is a linearly group, so it's a closed subgroup of GL. Linear subgroup G is a closed subgroup of GLR. What we call the linearly group. It's a closed subgroup of this. So it's a matrix. So matrix of the matrix, the bracket, the matrix is like this. For the matrix, for this here is a linear tensor. It's a linear tensor. If the bracket here is the bracket of two matrices, is that AB minus BA. It's exactly what we are going to get. Because you consider here G, which is the linear group, which is the closed subgroup of G and R. G is a closed subgroup of G and R. It's closed. Of this thing, this kind of also. Okay, so you have this is also, we have the proof that this is the relation between ED and this is exactly what you get. So you prove that AD of here, the derivative of AD at zero is exactly this kind of we can give the general case now for this kind of notation. Now, if you suppose that G like, let's find now a Hilbert notation like this, Hilbert notation of a group.
on some vector space, a vector space which is also finite dimensional. So we have this kind of shape. We can also define the representation. How can define the representation of this Lie algebra, which here, where here is the Lie algebra, of this kind of label. How can I define this? What I'm going to provide? Don't you have this kind of relation? Have this? You don't have d pi like this. D pi of x is x exactly the derivative also property of this one parameter sub pi of the exponential tx when t tends to 0. What is the difference? And you have this. Then you can prove that d pi here is exactly d pi here is exactly the representation of also of object into some more vector space into the what kind of vector space can do this differential of the vector space of this one. So it's also a representation. It's very easy to prove that representation of here. We just compute it. It's very simple because here is a linear algebra. So it's very in the vector space. If you want to compute the representation when of this Lie algebra, just compute the representation, the image by this representation of each element of the basis is wrong. Will be simple for you. I will give you a simple example. I'll give you a simple example, Alex. I'll give you an example of this. Let us suppose that let J be a linear affine transformation group. Affine transformation group like this. It's a group like the letter D, like this. It's a group determined by the form E, B, 0, 1, 1, A, like this, and B, in the name of R. If you compute the Lie algebra of J, it should be, however, it will be denoted by theoretical for all S2 like this, which generated by this kind of vector, where you can compute it in terms of S here, will be equal to 1, 0, 0, 0. And S2 equal 0, 1, 0, 0, this can be the basis of the Lie algebra. So the Lie algebra of this kind of affine transformation group is like the vector space generated by this two-dimensional. It's a two-dimensional vector because the dimension of here, this one depends only on the two parameters. So the dimension of a Lie group is just the number of parameters which we characterize your group. Okay, have this kind of thing. So when you have to compute your representation of this one, from group letter sector, let's set like this as a 4 by pi of BA of f of x like this. I'll put the left over A like this of f of s minus B over A. This one. I think f here is a square integral on R. So then you can put easy that pi here is a representation. Is a representation of G like this, of this G into this square root of R.
which is this Hilbert space. It's a representation. It's very easy to prove. It is proof. We just proved that. We just proved that if you have to complete it, you have proved that A, B, A, B prime, A prime, can be equal to pi, B, A, complete with pi, B prime, A prime. And when you complete the pi value, the identity map will be like form, like this form, 0, 1. Which identity must be the identity of your this space, this Hilbert space. So it feels like this very, very easy. So from here, how can I compute the representation of Italy algebra? So, pour le représenter of each algebra, you see that this algebra is generated by the vertices at this form 0, 0, 1, S2, the matrix of 0, 1, 0, 0. This S1 is the basis of the linear algebra of this table. Is the basis. S1, S2 is the basis of the linear algebra of affine linear transformation of real phase. So if you have to complete the representation of this kind of here, and we get to complete the representation of this here, to complete here, you just complete the run of each element of representation. Okay, put the so we can complete d pi of x1 and d pi of x2. For this, you have d pi of x1 is just the derivative over t of pi of this one parameter subgroup like this. When t tends to 0, we have this kind of map. From here, you can just compute it. You have the exponential tx1. If you compute this, by definition, it's like this. This is tx1, n by the factor n from 0 to infinity like this. And here, s is a diagonal matrix. Then S1 for all n is exactly 1 n 0 n and so 0 0 exactly 1 0 not n 0 0. Then S1 is exactly for all n here. S1 n is equal to S1. Then if you have here just the exponential of t S1 it's exactly S1, you put it outside and have the exponential of t. That's all. So if you have to complete it, you have to see something very, very easy. If you complete it, you have the exponential t s1 equals just the exponential t 0, 0, 0, 0 of like this. Then, if you want to complete the pi of the exponential t s1 like this, will be equal to use the definition A here, B is here. So you have exponential minus t of f x minus over t like this. Because it's minus t f x a minus t. qu'il y aura des feux. Then when we complete it, for this kind of hell, if you complete it, you have this, will be equal to minus exponential t f for x e from t. After you have minus, yeah, you are here, exponential minus t, and here you have x exponential minus t. This minus is also here. And f prime of x exponential minus t. Let's complete the derivative of this. When we complete now, our d pi of x1, which is this, which is at t equal to zero, you have just here, you have f minus f of x minus also 0, 0 minus x, f prime of x, which what is this one. So you can use this form to compute also for x d pi of f2, the quantities, you get this kind of representation of this one. Okay, thanks. Okay, yeah. We forget just a little of f here, of f of x here. You have f of f here. F of f here. It is okay. You got to put it so f here. This kind of map. Okay, that's right. And also, properties here. P2, we can put also P2, but you have this, if pi is the representation of K into this kind of vector space, and you have this kind of relation also that the pi of this kind of exponential of x is also equal to the exponential of the pi very important. Pi is the representation of this, and d pi is the representation of it algebra. It algebra of from the vector space is the it algebra. It's the five dimensional case of topics. Each algebra. And the particular case, when you take the adjoint case, you have the same rotation. I'll change my mic here. From here, you can also prove that you have the adjoint of the exponential of x here. Because this one is the element of the group, is also equal to the exponential of the small ad, the adjoint of the algebra, like this. It's just the same because of the ad here is just the derivative of the capital one of this. Because this one is like this. So you have this notion. So you have U1, it is just a consequence of this. And so you can use this kind of notation to prove that the fact that d pi like this, this pi is a representation of your you have to prove it. Is this just the algebra written by L of G studies. Okay, thanks. So then this property just summarize what you. What we did here, you have a representation here. This one is a derived representation. Pi of the exponential of x is exactly the exponential of the derived representation of pi of x. This one. And not only that, the derived representation of the adjoint representation of the Lie algebra. Or the Lie group is just the adjoint operator of the Lie algebra. So we can easily prove that also that we need really gain the power of the exponential of x, exactly the exponential of the last calculation of x. You can easily prove it. Some properties of for one parameter subgroup to prove this. You prove this should not only be this, because also is a particular representation. We can prove it at all. Okay, let us put the let's set for the proof. Let's set, for example, gamma 1 of t. Let's put it of equal by the exponential of t x like this. And gamma 2 of t. Let us put the exponential of t d pi of x. You put these two maps. Gamma 1 and gamma 2 are one parameter subgroup of JLN. Gamma 1 and gamma 2. 1 parameter subgroup of JLN and R. If you compute gamma prime one of zero, it's just this kind of derivative is the d pi of what here is of x, the exponential of t x here, where t tend to zero, which is exactly equal to the derived representation of x, exactly equal to this. When t tend to zero, you have exactly this. When you do the derivative of gamma at zero, and you do the same for gamma 2. If you do the same for gamma 2, you will say gamma 2 of 0 is also of this is d pi of x, like this, the exponential of d pi of x, the derivative of this, and when t tend to 0. When t tend to 0, you are exactly gamma 2 of 0 is also equal to 3 pi. Then you have gamma 1 of 0 equal to gamma pi. This one is of 0. Then for all t in R, you have a gamma 1 of t equal to gamma 2 of t. This is all. So you have your for t equal to 1, you have this what you are going to prove. This all. So because I just remind you something. When you have something, the proof is finished like that. You have what to prove. You see what you get already out of. Why from 0, the proof of 0, you have just suppose that this is what you have. Because if gamma 1, gamma 2 are one parameter subgroup, you take from here, from here, this means that gamma 1 of t exactly is exactly the exponential of t gamma prime 1 of 0. Of 0. And gamma 2 of t is the exponential t of gamma prime 2 of 0. That's all. So if you prove that gamma 1 prime of 0 is are equal, then this one are equal. What we are going to prove. Because any one parameter subgroup of this generator is like this one. So, just to put that the derivative at zero of one is equal to the derivative at zero of two, it is odd. So we have this one, very, very simple. And then you should prove it, since will be the same, for the two adjoint is the same, because the derivative of the adjoint here at zero is exactly zero. So we have this, the same notation like this. So then the AD of the exponential x is exactly the exponential of the derivative of this one, which is exactly AD of x. This one is the derivative of this at zero. This one. Okay? And now, I'll give you some more remark now. I give you some remark concerning to this kind of stuff. We define first of all the adjoint representation. The adjoint representation is a map into this map for object. We have the adjoint of putting the automorphic formula, which is called this also of automorphic of that is each will be the same. Will be the same. So from here you have J of 3 and you have S of what you are going to prove. Then you have AD of J of X. You put that it is equal to ASDX D minus 1. Here it's just a hashing. It's just DXY. It's just a hashing of G on X. G operates. That means that the G operates on it the algebra like this. Like this one. Like this, like this operation of this, like this. That means that what? It's just an action, this is an operation. It's just if you have what is the map G of it the algebra into it the algebra for all G here, X, but this action, G, it happens like this. Which is exactly denoted by this D1 of this. We just action the operation of G on iter Lie algebra. This action, this D operates, the group operates iter Lie algebra like this. Just from this operation, we deduce what we call the representation of your group, which is called the adjoint representation. Okay? Now, if you I can also suppose that I took the dual of this, the dual of AD. When you take the dual of AD, map of D also to the DL of the dual of this algebra. The dual of this. Then you have D also you have this the dual of this algebra. That is this map of the dual of this dual yeah this for all f here you have this the action of this number f when f here the element of the dual is a linear form on this one. So it's also an action also for the group. It's also the action, an operation for this. J operates like this. J operates like this. G point F like this. Where F is a linear form on this vector space. J like this. This action is what we call the adjoint. It's like this.
of Christendom. What do you call this here? The co-adjoint representation. It's called co-adjoint representation. The co-adjoint representation is just the action of the T on this the space of linear form of this vector space. We call it the co-adjoint representation. Or also, we can call this this one. Or here, the co-adjoint representation is defined by the graph of this kind of representation. Or we can call it also what you call the contragradient representation of the adjoint representation. From here, if you compute, the derivative, where you have AT, AT like this, then AT comes from T into TR of something like that. Then when I compute like this, the tangent space at T of ED of here will be in the algebra, the tangent space of here, which is the Lie algebra, is a tangent space at E of G into the tangent space at this, the tangent space of the image of E here, which is that F here. Your F, the image of F. If you put F here, you get it. So I'll put it like this for you. The tangent space of the image of E for the adjoint representation. Okay, we can put it and of DL of DL for something like that. Here is what you will call the adjoint, the co-adjoint representation of the adjoint representation of the algebra. Here is exactly this. Here is the adjoint representation. Here will be exactly the representation of E. Here is E. The representation of DL. This kind of thing. So it's also, we define also from all S here, we define also this action like this, which you call the co-adjoint representation of S. From here, from the dual of T to E to the from E, for F, you have an asymptote of this F. Then here is also in the action of here is the adjoint co-adjoint representation of S of F. That's a action of the also the Lie algebra on this. So we put also here is the action of the Lie algebra. The action here of the dual into the dual. So you have S here for F, like here, you have just S, which is just the action. What's called J in the Lie algebra operate on this linear form, like this one. It's called the co-adjoint representation of the Lie algebra. It's also co-adjoint, This is the, for the group. This is for the Lie algebra also. Just to the remark.